Man, another great one from Brad Sox. There's Something Wrong. I love it, man. Love it. I almost caught a part in there that was like, I want to be your dog. Where he's like, I want to be your man. I don't know if he was riffing on that or not. Welcome back, or good morning, afternoon, or evening, wherever you might be. Kinneas back for another round of training. I've been pulling my hair out. It's like being in school, man. So I've been challenged by some Germans. Well, let's just leave that out of it. I have been challenged to dogfight, and I know jack and bleep about dogfighting. Right? I'm just a sky dude. I just travel around and deliver cargo and, you know, that's about as exciting as it gets, you know, some thunderstorms. So yeah, wow. And this is heavy, man. This is seriously tray heavy. So I'm just gonna keep going through the training where we left off. I was trying to finish up this some bombing training here. If I had to do this all over again, start all over, I mean, I really started Friday, but I wish I would have done a couple of things Friday. I've already wasted a lot of time, and I'll get to those in just a moment. Okay. Okay, so let's pick it up here where we were. CCIP. Computer controlled impact point mode unguided bombs. This is very tricky. He's gonna go over the two types of bombs that we have. The Fab 100s, the Fab 500s. Don't worry about that. Can you believe they have no Fab 4 in this that I know of? Silly. Okay. Then we're gonna have to fly through some gates. Then we're gonna have to do a super steep dive at 60 degrees. And then we're supposed to line up and drop some bombs. And half the time, trying to do that dive will kill you. So here's to hopefully not dying a whole bunch of times trying to get these bombs on point. So, I mean, I know you're thinking, well, why are you doing unguided bombs if you're doing a dogfight challenge? You know, that's a really good question. I'm just trying to learn it all. Might as well learn it all at the same time, so that I continue doing missions with them and other things afterward. Right? So, learn it all. Here we go. CCIP mode unguided bombing. Digital combat world simulator. It's free, but everything else is really expensive. You want campaigns, mods, or the study level or training level aircraft? Oh my god, man. The good thing is right now, I mean, if you're really gung-ho about this, right now they're doing one of those super sales. Super sale from the 8th to the 18th. And you can get a whole bunch of stuff super cheap. But I don't know that I want to continue on
and the continuously computed
with more than this.
Or CCIP. Unguided bombs of the SU-25T include the Fab 100, Fab 250, Fab 500, RBK cluster bomb.
Oh, crap. I forgot to say, please, 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 if you're stopping in, please make yourself known in my chat room. That way, it's really simple for me to click on your name and choose go to channel and subscribe to you. It's so easy. And so it doesn't matter if you have content up or not. We all start somewhere with a blank page. So two folks came in last night and I said that, and they said hi in the chat room, and neither of them have any content up, but I was more than happy to subscribe. You need to follow or I'm it. So say hi in the chat room. Don't be a stranger.
Beta penetration bombs. In this case, I have two racks of Fab 100s and a couple of larger Fab 500s. Each of the Fab bombs has a high explosive warhead, and the number in the name indicates the bomb's weight in kilograms. I currently have the lesson in active pause. The first thing I need you to do is select air to ground mode by pressing 7. Do this now.
Done, sir. Or doesn't see me in the game. There we go.
Note that the HUD has changed.
I've noted it.
Most of the navigation information and replaced it with bombing symbology. We'll talk more about this soon. You can switch your weapons by pressing D. Try this now.
Okay, so one of the first things I wish I would have ever done when I first got into DCS World is read the manual a little bit more thoroughly. But there's so much that everything just kind of goes in one eye out the other. Gloss over it. But one of them is to change the cockpit HUD, the HUD, to English. And it will also make the female audio, whenever she's her warning messages, in English. So that helps a lot. I've been taking notes for all the Russian translations, trying to figure out the Russian translations in the hub, in the HUD. That's not been fun. But Now I know the translations, and I've been got a new notebook over here that I'm quickly filling up.
When you cycle a weapon, take a look at the weapon status panel in the bottom center of the front dash.
Okay.
It's the black panel with the shape of a wing along the top. There are two rows of lights below it. The top row of yellow lights indicates the weapon stations that have weapons attached to them. And the lower row of green lights indicates weapon stations that are loaded with the currently selected weapon type. In the top right corner of the panel, a B symbol is displayed. This indicates that the selected weapon type is a bomb. You can also see the symbol in the lower right corner of the HUD. By pressing left control and spacebar, you can set the ripple quantity, meaning how many bombs are released when you press and hold the weapon release button or trigger. Try this now.
Okay, the two knobs on that panel, we're looking at the one on the right at the moment. Control, spacebar.
As you cycle ripple quantity, take a look at the weapon control panel in the lower left portion of the front dash. On the panel are two knobs. The right knob has positions for X1, X2, X4, and BCE. Those are the basics configuring your settings for bomb release. Now let's learn how to put those bombs on target in CCIP mode. Using what you learned in the navigation lessons, fly through all the gates ahead. Press the space bar to unpause the lesson.
Okay, before I do that, the one on the left, using the V key, I'm not sure what position one is, I'm not really getting that. But position two is 0.1 seconds between bomb drops, 0.2 seconds between bomb drops, 0.3, 0.4, and that's drop everything. Okay, over here on the other side is drop one bomb, drop two bombs, drop four bombs, or drop everything. Okay, so now looking back over here, if the message up at the top of the screen, his instructions go away while you're looking at things, hit escape once, go to message history, right? And then he wanted me to hit the space bar to unpause the lullition, hit escape again. And then resume. Spacebar.
If you are not already, press 7 to enter air to ground mode. On the HUD, you can see a pipper with a dot in the center. This is your bombing reticle, and we'll use it to aim your bombs. When you're within valid bomb release parameters, indicated by the launch authorization cue on the HUD, the bombs will impact where the bombing reticle pipper is at time of weapon release.
Okay, but what he doesn't tell you, at the end of this row of gates, I'm going to make you do a super dive. You're going to dive like you've never dived before. Okay. If you need to get a cursor, normally in default mode, whenever you move the mouse in here, the camera goes with it. If you need it to stop, or let's say you have a plane that allows you to use cockpit controls, or you just want to get a cursor, hit Alt C. That gives you a cursor, stops the camera from moving when you move, and you can either click things, and we might look at some Mustang training, and I'll show you, they have a clickable cockpit. But what are Oh, come on. It's like somebody's calling you. Hello? This is crazy. There's one. They have amazing flaps, and they're able to turn so quickly. I don't see them at all. They had to go land, and I have no idea. Well, what I can say is we survived. Yeah, Doc, come back. Huh. Well, folks, I don't know. I don't know where they went. They gave up. Which is fine by me. I'll take the win. It's not going to give me a win because I didn't get either of them. But I managed to try to do everything right with regarding the turning, right? So when you're passing an opponent or he's circling on you, you're supposed to circle faster. And whoever can reach, okay, imagine a circle when you're turning. Whoever can reach like the top of the circle the quickest usually can turn faster. And you need to be pretty much laying sideways. And maybe even hitting a, you know, keep toggling the speed brake on and off. Keep your finger on that. And just concentrating on doing those kind of maneuvers as I was doing circles. Kept us alive. But that doesn't give us a win. Nope, nope. All right, so nose to nose.
8 kilometers ahead are two.
When you're going nose to nose,
use your R60M and R73 missiles to shoot them down. Press escape and then select briefing to view a list of useful key commands.
Do the circle faster. Let me stop.
Fuel 1500.
He's gonna come up. He went up. Is gonna go down again. Go this way. Man, and then did he change direction again? Flares. Oh my.
WS failure. ECM failure. Hydraulics failure.
Crazy.
Kilometers ahead are two A-10s coming directly at you. Use your R60M and R73 missiles to shoot them down. Press escape and then select briefing to view a list of useful key commands.
Come on.
1500.
I don't know where they go. Well, it's not really a good dogfight if they leave. Okay. How interesting. So, I guess, I don't know, maybe... I don't know. Pilot dead, crash, mission end. Dead. No, we don't want mission. Go back to instant action. We'll try something else. Close air support. It's supposed to be easy. Ha! At waypoint 1, on the east side of the river, are 4 enemy armor vehicles that are blocking your troops from pushing south. The enemy force is marked with red smoke. This is your primary target. Southeast of the town, they're defending is a battery. Of the town, they're defending is a battery of 4 artillery pieces, also marked with red smoke. Secondary target. Okay, first thing, what do we got? whole lot of stuff. Okay, so the ones on the outside, as I understand it, are air-to-air. Two on the inside, let's go back. Blast fragmentation. I don't know. Rockets. 2 kilometers. Unguided. Scum 80. All right, let's get in the cockpit. Okay. The SK-8OM, right? The S-8KOM. The S-8KOM, which is currently loaded. So now I gotta refer to my notes. 20 rockets. They shoot 2 miles. And they're armor penetrating. That one shouldn't have a blast frag. Okay. We were to... Unpause, hit D, pause. Okay, the ones that are third in from the end on each side... are bombs. Okay. The third in on each side. I think those are tank, anti-tank. And then the two on the inside look to be optically guided and possibly laser guided. Okay. So we have out there somewhere. Do some recon. We have an armor group and then 4 artillery groups. We also have a guy with us that's flying with us. So, let me refer back to some earlier notes on how to make another aircraft out there at least follow you. Give them something else to shoot at, I suppose, other than me. I don't know how to designate a target or have it go after my target yet. Here it is. Nearest air, no, that's not it. Join up in formation. Left window Y. There's a guy out there, so let's go back in here. Left window Y.
You know, what?
So there's a guy over here. There he is. And we're telling him to join our formation. Okay, now let's swoop in and do some recon. Okay. One of those down there is artillery and one is armor. Oh. Okay. Two on the inside were the laser guided. Okay. Loud. Can't tell if those are artillery or not. Oh. Well, those pesky trees. There's no way I'm going to be going. There's no way I'm going to be going to War Thunder either without at least being able to do some of this. Hey, Henning's out there. Good morning. Good morning, good morning. So, hello. You're looking at chat, listening, but not typing since you just woke up. It's 4 a.m. Yep. It is early. Cheers. I've got some tea. I'm a nice cuppa. Oh. My goodness. It's been a nothing but failures again. And failure after failure after failure after failure. But I did get to put some of the dogfighting techniques that I watched in some videos to test. And some of them have worked okay. You know, doing a, whatever you call it, the high G barrel roll. Let's see, which techniques did I employ? I employed... the high G barrel roll, and I also tried guns defensive jinking, and I tried a high yo-yo, where you go up, invert, and then roll downward, and I did some scissoring. So... and some of them worked all right. Some of them I didn't think I nailed. But the high G barrel roll, those worked pretty good. I refer to some other notes here. Flares are delete. Chaff is insert. Left wing G or left wing Q is attacking my target. Cover me, left wing W. Attack air defenses. All right, let's try that instead of having him form up. Seven. That's the one on that side. Let's think about what I saw there. And first, let me unpause and have him to go to attack air defenses. Unpause, shift, win D. Win D.
Zino, атакуй ПВО.
That's right. Go get him. Rawr, go get him. Okay. That weapon, again, out there is the... S8K. U E. Oh, you can't do that. I wish. Do they have? I couldn't find an active pause, one where you can pause but still do things. I guess they consider that cheating. So this has high energy explosive warheads. Let me just go stick to reconning. Yep. What he said. It looks like one thing, but there are three or more. And then there's a whole bunch. Jack. Nothing. On what? And then I popped the blast radius of my own bomb there. What were the 29Ts? The 29T... It's the 29T. Cage 29T missile. 12 miles. Armor.
Fuel 1500.
Where's the red smoke? You took the smoke away. Well, how's that gonna help me? I don't know. I don't know what I'm shooting at anymore. I don't know what my targets are. How bad it's running. It's lagging so bad. It's like the last one. It's like they go away. No, it still says they're there. Sucks.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm not sure what's going on. Everything is really lagging too. So maybe it's time to wrap this one up and restart the computer. Not entirely sure. But I think that is what I will do. Just give everything a nice restart. So thank you for tuning into this live stream. I might come back and do another one later. And or might just continue watching videos on dogfighting. So thank you for tuning into this one, and I will catch you. If I don't catch you later in the evening, if I just sit around and watch videos for the rest of the night, I'll pick it up tomorrow at 1 p.m. in the afternoon, our regularly scheduled time for these live streams. These are all extras. Well, I got to get all this practice in. So, all right, let's play us out with the song we played in. Our featured song for this live stream has been Brad Sucks, There's Something Wrong. See you later or tomorrow.